Tariq so soon. How did you feel when that fight was offered to you?
You know, I was honored that they would offer me that fight so quickly, and I was just excited and right back in training camp to fight her. So I'm excited.
What do you find is the most challenging element of her game?
You know, she has a very strong Muay Thai game. That's kind of what she's been known for, but I do think she's a predictable fighter. She's been around for a very long time, so she's kind of already got her style set in stone, whereas I'm very young, obviously, and I can still change my style. I have a lot to learn, and she's not going to know what's coming for her.
When you had your first fight, you were so happy. You were just smiling, and I had a conversation with somebody saying that her youth made her fearless, but it was kind of that good feeling of, like, not fearless because she's stupid. It's fearless because she's just young and excited. Do you feel that way when you fight?
I definitely do. I know I don't have anything to lose. I'm going in there. I have a lot to prove, but I don't have anything to lose. Everything, I'm going to go out there and do my best, and whatever happens is going to be great.
How do you feel about your spot in the rankings since this came out?
I'm very happy to be ranked number 10th. That's awesome. I can't wait to move on up the ladder, and I just want to continue fighting people that are ranked higher than me so I can continue moving up the ladder.
Ahead of your last training camp, you hadn't been down to Team Alpha Male, but I know that sometimes you do train there. Where will you be training for this camp, up in Reno, or will it be with the Team Alpha Male?
I will be with Team Alpha Male as well, but I do have a personal trainer that's based out of Reno, so I do go back and forth, which I'm fine with. I have family, and I'm from Reno, Nevada, so I still go back and forth, but I'm fighting out of Team Alpha Male.
You touched upon this previously in an interview saying that you and Felice were the two hottest chicks around. But if you look at how MMA fans sort of see the female fighter, does it bother you the amount of sort of sexism that gets involved and how they sort of perceive women based on her looks instead of her fighting?
You know, I think that me and her will always get perceived that way. You know, I was saying that's what other people think about us. And, you know, we were born this way. It's nothing that we can change. And that just means that we both have to prove that we're the toughest people out there. I'm going to go out there and prove that I'm not just a pretty face.
There were some other fighters who weren't happy with those comments. Did their reaction surprise you, or was it just what you expected?
No, it's definitely what I expected. You know, I was bullied a lot in high school, and I think a lot of that had to do with, I guess, my looks. There's going back, I wouldn't change it because they made me stronger, and I'm too strong for them to shake me.
Now you've kind of had the chance.
You were pretty?
Yeah, you know, high school was pretty rough for me, so I actually graduated. I went to college when I was 16 just to get out of the whole high school thing. I didn't want to deal with any of that anymore, so, you know, I went through so much that everything that happens now, no matter what people say, these are people that I don't know and they're people I don't think about, so whatever they say doesn't faze me.
Well, now you kind of have the chance to be a role model, so you've been doing a lot of photo shoots, a lot of modeling with some other magazines. How does that role feel for you?
It's amazing. I really want to be a voice for young girls that have also been bullied. You know, I went through a lot growing up, and it's things that if I talked about, you wouldn't even believe. It was a rough few years in high school, so I just want to be a voice for them. I want to say that you don't have to play the victim. You can play the survivor and the fighter.
Looking back at your UFC debut, you won a bonus, and you got a spectacular finish. Would you say that that's perhaps the perfect UFC debut for you?
It was perfect. I'm very fortunate that, you know, I didn't have to go through the Ultimate Fighter. It would have been an amazing experience and a great opportunity, but I went out there and pulled off a very dominant win, and I think that proved that. That was one step closer to being known as a tough fighter and not just the pretty one.
Is there a fighter whose career you admire that you feel like I'd love to follow in that person's footsteps?
Ronda Rousey, of course. I mean, look at her. She's an amazing athlete. She was an Olympian. She has really created a draw behind women's MMA, and if I can follow her path but create my own footsteps, I just would be blessed.
When you talk about those footsteps, does it include possibility of, like, movies and things of that nature as well?
Of course. I mean, that would be a great opportunity, but right now the only thing on my mind is beating Felice Herrig.
Is Ronda someone who you have any contact with? Have you spoken with her about sort of being a female in the fight game?
I haven't, but I found out she follows me on Twitter today, so that was awesome.
So the storyline is that you were too young to be in the Ultimate Fighter, right? But after seeing how the show played out, do you feel like you dodged a bullet? Some of the girls got a lot of criticism for this season.
I definitely feel like I dodged a bullet. I would have loved to work with those coaches. I mean, I think they're amazing athletes. Their whole coaching team would have been an awesome experience. It would have been a lot of growth from being on the show, but the fact that I didn't have to, and I still got the opportunity to fight for the UFC, I got the opportunity to get that bonus, it was a blessing in disguise, and I definitely wouldn't change it for the world.
If we look at your division, the biggest fight coming up is, of course, between Carla Esparza and Joanna Jędrzejczyk. How do you look at that fight, and who do you have picked as a winner?
I still think Carla's wrestling is going to be an outmatch for Joanna. I think Carla's got... She's perfected a skill where Rhonda has perfected arm bars and Carla has perfected wrestling. And until she goes against someone who can have a really strong defense against her wrestling, I don't think she's going to fall from the title.
Do you feel you have that type of defense?
I know that I am at the best camp in the world for wrestling. So when I get the opportunity to fight her, my wrestling will be just as good as hers.
Thank you, cool. Thank you very much.